Common, the Iceman, Gerwyn Price.
Vegas are pumping, quick to the point, no faking. Cooking MCs like a pound of bacon, burning them, you're not quick and nimble. I go crazy when I hear a cymbal and a hi-hat with a souped-up tempo. I'm on a roll, time to go solo.
Gerwyn Price tritt gegen einen Mann an, der zunächst einmal die Haare schön hat. Das ist die Nummer 5 der Welt. Er ist der WM-Finalist von 2014. Er hat vor 2 Jahren die European Darts Open hier in Düsseldorf gewonnen. Aus Schottland, Snakebite, Peter Wright!
I think you're having a good time.
Tell you what, Dan, it's a big wide stage that Peter Wright's got here in Düsseldorf, isn't it? But the dancing has stopped and it's time for the games to begin once again. The final match in the top half of the section, Stephen Bunting and Terry Jenkins safely through to meet tonight in the quarterfinals. These two meeting for the right to face Mensur Sulubic in the last 8 from 7 o'clock this evening as well. Peter Wright, a former champion here in Düsseldorf, beating Simon Whitlock in the final of 2014. Gerwyn Price, who knows, this could well be his year. He's moving in the right direction once again, and he absolutely destroyed the former European champion Simon Whitlock yesterday. How do you see this one going?
Well, if these two players they did in the previous round, there's only one winner, and it's the Welshman, because Gerwyn Price was phenomenal against Simon Whitlock in the opening stages. First two legs, he took out 1-4-4 and then 1-6-1. He averaged 100 by the end of it, and Simon Whitlock just did not get a look in. Whereas Peter Wright had to survive 4 match darts from Steve West. In the end, he did average 97. I mean, it wasn't that bad, but he was just put under the cosh for large parts of the game, and he was relying on his opponent missing rather than going out there and beating him without giving him a chance. So look, Peter Wright has work to do to improve. However, can Gerwyn replicate that level of performance that he produced against Simon Whitlock? Huge opportunity for anybody in this half of the draw. You've got some massive names in this tournament still left in the Happy Bet European Darts Open. But world champion Gary Anderson, 2-time European champion Kim Huybrechts, or Euro Tour champion, I should say, Kim Huybrechts. James Wade, multiple champion. Jelle Klaassen, former world champion. Michael Van Gogh in the world number one. They're all in the other half of the draw.
This is the place to be.
Well, it really is. I mean, look, you've still got 9-time major finalist Terry Jenkins, former world champion Stephen Bunting, and the ever superb Mensur Sulubic in this half of the draw. But look, it seems a little more inviting than the other half. So big chance, and Gerwyn Price will be hoping to make it through to the final session action on a European Tour weekend for a third time.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. First leg going to throw first. Game on!
Well, the word you use there, improve, that's something that Gerwyn Price certainly did as far as the step up in class he put in as opposed to his first match. Tony Newell, 6-3, an average of 84, 6 out of 22 on his doubles. and then an average of over 100, as you say, against Simon Whitlock. It was a huge step up in class from Gerwin Price yesterday, given the way he performed in the first round. It wasn't convincing at all against Tony Newell. Very scratchy opening match, but having got through that opening hurdle, he certainly built on it.
99.
Well, he did win his first two PDC titles this year, did Gerwin Price, and the first one he won, he beat this man in the final. And I know that
100.
Not all of the top players were there, but he still beat some serious players. And one of them is the world number five, Peter Wright. And that has got to stand him in good stead for this match
41.
Here. It was his first win against Snakebite. He'd lost twice before, once at the match play last year, and once on his debut at the World Championship, Ali Pally. He got beaten 3-0.
60.
So they have all been significant meetings for Gerwin Price, at least. You know, debut at the Worlds, debut at the match play, and then in the final of his first
100
PDC title.
Going to require 161.
The 161, he can't do it again, can he? Well, he won't. Did take it out against Simon Whitlock in the opening stages yesterday.
87.
Yeah, that was for a 2-0 lead after taking out the opening 144.
Shanghai for Peter Wright needs to find the treble for a dart at tops. Ah, oh, lovely dart. A 15 darter.
80.
Just above the wire.
Going to require 74.
74 is not a gimme. Treble 14. Oh, he's gone 18, so that leaves double 10. Yeah, good finish from Gerwin Price, and he does hold his throw, and so 1-0 up here.
Well, that will have settled him down, no doubt about that. Sometimes people say or suggest that it's good to have an early scare, as indeed Peter Wright had yesterday. It sort of, you know, get something out of his system, maybe.
Well, there are scares.
And there are.
And then they're absolutely
frightening.
Yeah. Unending nightmares, 60. Which is kind of what Peter Wright was put through yesterday against Steve West. He trailed 5-2. There appeared to be only one winner in that match, but things changed, and Peter Wright now finding the treble bed. That's his first maximum of this match. He is using these darts. I've not talked to him about these specific darts, but
68.
These are a thinner barreled one with a longer point. You would think he's change to these specifically to try and hit more maximums, and I'm looking to set this up. Turn 40 to leave 56.
100.
As it is, it's still a two darter he's left. Could well be an 11 dart leg coming in from Peter Snake by Wright. Number two seed here this weekend.
95. Penny require 96.
Yep, sets it up. Plenty of opportunity here with Price on 278 and unable to find the treble until the third dart. Still not down to a finish. And this should be a leveling throw.
Third leg going to throw first. Game on.
Yeah, 6-3 the score when Gerwin Price beat Peter Wright in that final in Barnsley earlier this year.
Yeah, denying Snakebite his ninth PDC title by claiming his first. And is this the first 180 from Gerwin Price? It is that.
180.
I would think Peter Wright will have the majority of the support from this German crowd. He is incredibly popular over here. Sells a lot of his merchandise over here. About 500 t-shirts a year, I'm told.
100.
Prominent on the displays when you go looking around.
A few wigs as well. Probably, if, I mean, difficult. If you're Peter Wright fan. Yeah, I like Peter Wright. I want to throw darts like he's throwing. I don't really have that option because he changes them every other week. Oh, look at this going price. Another big finish for the weekend. You bet it is. You bet it is. 1-3-8 from Gerwin Price. It's the only way to go to treble 19. Add that to the 1-4-4 and the 1-6-1 he took out in the last game against Simon Whitlock. Puts him 2-1 up here.
Yeah, carrying on where he left off to some extent there. And then with his first dart finds the treble one.
Not sure Gerwin Price has branched out into the darts merchandise market as yet. Tell you what,
strap on muscles. Just sling him over the shoulders.
He could shift some units of whatever he decides. I mean, he's more likely to be advertising Gerwin Price protein shakes.
Do you know what? In the bar last night, after you left,
you can have a Gerwin Price protein shake.
There was Gerwin Price walked in with Devin Peterson. It was just...
That's a lot of beef.
I thought I'm not even going to think about moving at the moment.
23.
I'll stay here. Slink under the table.
A 1-4-2 for Peter Wright. Can he respond with a big check out of his own? Well, he stayed there for double 11. Interesting choice, bearing in mind that Gerwin isn't on a finish. But he has set it up very nicely.
Certainly has.
Set it up nicely if he fires in a maximum here, Gerwin. Oh, there's loads of room there. But he has left a nice little two-darter. Peter Wright, though, he's relying on Snakebite missing this. Double eight. Double four.
Anxious times here for Peter Wright. Gerwin waiting in the wings, prowling around at the back of the stage, but he won't return in this fourth leg because Peter Wright takes out double four for 2-2. Yeah, it was a bit like Venice Beach last night in that bar when Devon and Gerwin got together.
100.
So I'm told. I've never actually been. Elmar told me that.
Right, yeah, Elmar would know. Phil Taylor did have a line of protein shakes lined up to parade.
Phil Taylor used to live in Venice Beach.
No, I don't think so. More likely to be found on Blackpool Beach.
Likes it there, does Phil?
59.
Chance now for Peter Wright. Look at those averages. 101 plays 98. Good standard in the opening four legs. And Peter Wright looking to get a first breaker throw in this match. And that will help. A second maximum for Snakebite. We have seen a couple of big averages this weekend. 60. None bigger than Gary Anderson, the world champion and former World Cup of Darts partner of Peter Wright. Threw 107.11 last night, the fourth highest average we've ever seen at this European Darts Open.
100.
Peter Wright averaging around about that 105 mark at the minute. Potential 11 dart leg coming in as he looks to get the first break of throw. And go 3-2 up, take the lead for the first time in the match. And he's got six darts from here minimum. So he is going at the treble 19, and that's perfect. Now double 12. And that is perfect as well. 11 darter to break. And if Gerwin Price was unsure of the caliber of opponent he's up against, well, now he is left in little doubt.
Yeah. Timely reminder, good illustration of Peter Wright's ability there. Looked like one of those matches that was going to keep on ticking over until the closing stages, but Peter Wright has just seized the initiative there. Yeah, 107 for Anderson, 104 for Van Gerwen in that 6-0 demolition of Jamie Caden, 103 for Mentor Sulevic yesterday, and Alan Norris in defeat, an average of 101 against Kyle Anderson.
100.
Just the 2 180s yesterday for Peter Wright, so he's matched that already today.
58.
Yeah, right, moving across and... Well, 91. Comes down for the treble 17 and that leaves 170. We've already seen 138 check out from Derwin Price. See, at 161 yesterday was the biggest we've seen this weekend. Can Peter Wright give us the big one? No, he cannot.
Still in a very good position here, though, Peter Wright, to hold his throat and to extend his lead. And to put a bit of daylight between these two for the first time in this match. But then again, Gerwin Price might have something to say here.
139. Pay you require 110.
Well, still the favourite to see off this leg and make it 4-2, Peter Wright. He'll 90 left, so bull or treble 18. He went treble for double 18.
58. Going to require 150. Pity you require 52.
20 for double 16 to consolidate that break of throw and go 4-2 up. The number two seed, Peter Wright. Well, he's going 12 tops. That's only just in the 12. Game but that is right there. In the tops. Peter and Wright. It is 4-2. And Gerwin Price, well, for the first time this weekend, is being put under some serious pressure.
Yeah, was he swayed there by the fact he missed double 16 earlier on? Maybe, not sure. Anyway, it doesn't matter. He got the job done. But he did have a lot of room for manoeuvre there anyway, so...
93.
4-2.
And reminder, this game will complete the quarter-final lineup in the top half of the draw. We've already seen Stephen Bunting, former Lakeside World Champion, and nine-time major finalist Terry Jenkins set up our opening quarter-final clash. That'll be the first game on this evening as Peter Wright hits 180 number three.
180.
Mensur Suljević awaits the winner of this.
58.
That'll be the second game on this evening. Four quarter-finals, then the two semis and the final on the way in tonight's climactic session of European Darts Open Darts. As that's just a ton 40, but it's enough for Peter Wright. Potentially another 11 dart leg coming in here to break again and put Gerwin Price on the brink of an exit in the last 16.
Well, Peter Wright at the moment making the most of his good fortune that came his way yesterday.
52.
Interesting from Peter Wright there. Well, he could have had his choice of doubles to leave. He's decided to leave for double 18. It's not one that he leaves on a regular basis because the switch over to double 9, if you come inside, is not his favourite. But it doesn't matter if you pin it, and that's what he's done. And it's a 14 darter to break. And Gerwin Price, as excellent as he was yesterday, he's not been able to sustain that level after the opening two or three legs.
Yeah, it looked as though he might be able to do that. He started off really well, 74 checkout in the opener, 138 checkout in the third for a 2-1 lead, and it looked as though he was carrying on from where he left off yesterday, but Peter Wright has just really taken control of this now, and that's pretty indicative of the way that Gerwin Price and things are going for him at the moment.
81
scored.
Yeah, and our fancy darts statistic website that's been given an overhaul. I'll even give you a breakdown in the stats for individual darts.
Like the second dart average, for example.
Yeah, but the Gerwin Price's first dart, whereas yesterday against Simon Whitlock, it was superb. 60. It was that dart was upon what he built his visits upon. But he's only averaging 24, less than 25 with that first dart, Gerwin Price, because it's not been finding its mark, and that does make things a lot harder for you. That first dart is not giving you a guide. It's not where it needs to be. That's a blocker dart there, you see.
58. Do you require 131?
Whereas Peter Wright's first dart is 37.5 average. So an absolute chasm between the pair of them.
Yeah, and a chasm between the three-dart averages as well here. But 95. It's in danger of just fizzling out, this one. It promised a lot more than it's delivered so far, this particular match.
Well, let's have it right. Peter Wright has played very, very well. He's left double 18 for the match. He's averaging 104.5 right now, and this is for a 6-2 win. The number two seed, Peter Wright, over for double 9. Gets it through to the quarterfinals, and Peter Wright ends Gerwyn Price's run. It'll be no third Euro Tour quarterfinal for the Welshman. 103 average for Snakebite. He will take on Mensur Suljevic, the Austrian, in the second quarterfinal tonight. That is the top half of the draw done ahead of the evening session. We're now going to have a look at the bottom half of the draw, and the world champion is about to take to the stage. Gary Anderson, the Flying Scotsman, is up against a two-time Lakeside semi-finalist in Jan Dekker, one of the surprise packages of this weekend.
Peter, congratulations. Much better than yesterday. Average of 104. That was the way we know you here in Düsseldorf.
I've always rubbish. Can I just, can you translate to the crowds or the adults? Be careful, all the little kids trying to get up. They're right at the railings and, you know, you're squashing them. Be careful.
Peter sagt gerade, soll ich ihm übersetzen, passt hier vorne auf mit den Kindern. Die werden ansonsten zerquetscht am Zaun. Einfach vorsichtig sein, alle sind heiß auf die Flights. Yeah, thanks for the information. That's good. So, Mensur Suljevic is the next one. You've never lost against him.
I love playing Mensur.
Why?
Because he's a proper professional. And he's... He tries every single die, and he's amazing. He's a character as well. Crowd love him, so it should be a fantastic game.
Yeah, we're looking forward to that. Thank you very much. Peter Wright, Snakebite. Ihn sehen wir heute Abend also dann wieder im Viertelfinale gegen Mensur Suljevic.